Big news this week when it comes to protecting people of all ages from the respiratory illness known as RSV. Here to break it all down is Dr. John Brownstein, an infectious disease specialist at Boston Children's Hospital.
Dr. Brownstein, it's great to see you as always. Thanks for your time this afternoon. So let's start with the youngest of us all. This week, the FDA approved the first vaccine to protect newborns from RSV. We know how protective new parents are of their little ones. What do you want them to know about this decision and that shot?
Well, this is exciting news. The vaccine called Abrysvo is given actually to pregnant women in the second or third trimester, and it's one dose. It's the first ever maternal RSV vaccine, which means it's given during pregnancy to pass that protection on to newborns. It's this passive immunity to the fetus. So this is not actually a shot for kids, but a shot for the mom. That immunity won't last forever, but it's expected to provide protection against RSV, which can be deadly in kids in the first 6 months of life, up to 80%. So it's an amazing vaccine for the mom. We still have to wait for CDC green light, so that will likely be October, so that's coming. In the meantime, we do have this monoclonal antibody shot for kids under 8 months of age, so you can still get that while we're waiting for this new vaccine. Overall, amazing news to get that protection for our little ones.
Yeah.
Now, as for all adults, last year, adult RSV hospitalizations were the highest on record, and we know there's been vaccine fatigue since the pandemic eased, but clearly this virus poses a serious risk, and now we have this new weapon available to fight it. How do you convince people to roll up their sleeves and get it this fall?
Well, it's going to be a massive public health challenge, really, because we have all these vaccines, but you just have to look at the data. RSV is mild for most, but it can lead to really severe consequences for our youngest and oldest members of society, especially if you have underlying conditions. You know, every year, RSV leads to tens of thousands of hospitalizations in our kids under five and in older adults. So that vaccination is going to be the best way to protect yourself and those around you from RSV. And of course, you know, there's going to be vaccine fatigue. We have COVID, flu, and RSV vaccines, but we're trying to prevent that triple-demic, right? All these viruses circulating at once. Everyone should have that conversation with their provider around risks and benefits on these vaccines.
And Dr. Brownstein, let's go from there. Let's talk about the C word, COVID. We know cases are ticking up again. So let me break it down. We're knocking on the door of school. Should kids be getting the COVID boosters before they head out to class? And what about their parents?
It's a great question. This is probably the question I'm getting the most right now. What should you do? Well, we are going to have this updated booster, which is going to be a better match to the circulating variants. That's coming probably mid to late September. So probably the best thing to do is just wait a few more weeks for that updated vaccine. That being said, if you're in a high-risk category or if you have exposure to connected to those that are high risk or you're potentially traveling, you may want to get that updated that booster right now. But for the most part, it's time just to wait and get that sort of better shot, that better booster. But of course, as always, consult your healthcare provider about your options.
Got it.
Good reminders. All right, Dr. Brownstein, thank you so much for joining us this afternoon.
Thanks, Dr. Brownstein. Good to see you.